Hello, and welcome back to this awesome, super amazing Premiere tutorial. My name is Jacob Staley, as you can see with this, lower thirds right here. And I'll be going through some basics for the mini classes of Premiere and how awesome it is. So make sure you follow along. All right, so for starting a new project, or what I would advise is that you want to create some type of folder that you're going to be working in during this entire time. So for the simple purpose, I'm going to open up this project, and then I'm going to go ahead and open up Premiere and get that all settled and ready. For Premiere and everything, you want to make sure your settings are pretty compatible with your computer, or else there will be an error message. Sometimes I get those on my computer and I have to download a certain program or whatnot. But to start a new project, all you have to do is just click new project, and you can name that whatever. So just project, and make sure you put it in a certain spot where you'll be able to find it. So as you created the folder earlier, I'm gonna do it new into project, and you can just throw it in there for right now. So all of this really doesn't matter as much. It's more advanced stuff, but we're gonna go ahead and jump in here, and we're gonna go ahead and import some footage and sound. So you can, if you want to. Sometimes I go into editing, but most of the time I go to assembly for this part, especially if you're gonna sync sound and whatnot. So we're gonna go ahead and import some footage here. So like I said, you can either double click here. You can either go into File, Import, or you can do, as the keyboard shortcut says right here, is just Control-I. To make a new sequence, all you have to do is you can either do Control-N, or you can click right down here and sequence. There are different type of presets that you can do. Usually what I do is do HDV. And then just do a 1080 or whatnot, but you can make your own presets for all that. So I just go ahead and make that, and you have your sequence right here. So for labeling new sequence, you can either, you can change the color of how that, the boxes, or if you're actually shooting movies, there are different types of labeling for sequences. So we'll actually go ahead and create some of our bins, which are this button down here. As you can see, it says new bin. So for the bins, for whatnot, so you have 099, which is for rough cuts. Then we have 199, which is for editor's cut. Then we have 299, which is director's cut, 399, which is the producer's cut, and then 499 is the final cut. So every time you open up a sequence and whatnot, you'll have to label it a certain way. So for this instance, say we're just doing a rough cut, so will be our 099B1. Yeah. So, and you can see it and all that. So, so you'll throw it in this bin right here. And whenever you do go into your editor's cut, you can go ahead and right click that, and you can go to duplicate. And then you can drag it down to your editor's cut, and then you can click just once, and you can rename this 199V1. And so if I double click on this, it should open up down here. But for this purpose, we'll be working in rough cut. So if you want to examine the clip that you just imported, you can double click this. Or you should honestly just go into the editing window, but you can double click your actual clip. It'll show you what your clip looks like. So that's, we have me just entering and exiting with the lightsaber that I did for production design. And so you can, in the source menu, you can do in and out points, so that takes only a certain segment of the clip. So you can click O, or there's these buttons that you can go down here for mark in and mark out and removing it, which is Control Shift O, Control Shift I. Mark out is O, and then mark in is I. So like this button right here is me marking out. Say I only want this certain portion of the clip of me walking in and then standing in frame, you can do that. And so for inserting, what you can do is there's this key cue. You can either press the button or use the keyboard shortcut, comma. And so for press comma, it should enter it into the clip. So I could just press as many times as I want and just keep inserting it and whatnot. If for whatever reason I want almost this entire clip and I want to do an overwrite edit, I can do a period and it should just overwrite everything. If I was going to do an insert edit, it would push everything open. So. For just if you say you wanted a picture of the picture over here, but you wanted the sound of the project over here, is say your in and out points, drag in the video only with this right here, just drag, and as you can see right here, it only drags in. If you wanted to drag in, and like I said, the audio over here, you can grab this waveform right here. You should grab just the audio. For the cut tool and whatnot, basically the purpose of the cut tool is so to trim certain bits in the timeline. So you can either go over to here to the razor tool, or you can press C as it says right there. So I am going to press C. You should be able to just trim that out. You can delete it, or if you wanted to, you could always move it. So, how to do a lift edit. Basically, what you can do is, so say you went to in and out this certain point right here. So this only this part of the video is selected and being recognized by the actual program. You can press these buttons over here, which is the semicolon or the apostrophe. So if I click semicolon, it should just lift it up. And then if I click the apostrophe for that, it should push everything together and takes out what was there. It's like kind of a snap thing going on. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut a small portion of these over and just make a little bit of a jump cut. So we have here to here. I'm going to show you how to do the ripple tool. So you go over to here, to your ripple edit tool. And there's different types of tools that you can do. We're going to use B. You click that and you can go to any certain part of the clip right here. And you can drag this way, or you can drag this way, which it will condense it down, but it will extend the clip to a certain point. I normally use rolling edit just because it cuts this clip and this clip like it moves along. And then we have the trim tool. So that is just the basic little selection tool. And you should be able to just drag certain clips and you can adjust the clip duration based off that and what's in there. So, and then we have the trim edit with tool, which if you just click T, it should give you certain parts of each of these frames. So like I said, that's T. So if you wanted the trim backwards 5 frames, you can click this and it should go jump back 5 frames. So you can click this as many times as you want and then it'll jump it back. So basically, one of the ways to link and unlink clips is you can click a certain clip, and you can right click it, and this entire menu pops up, and you can click unlink. So that video a certain place with the audio attaching. So if I went like this, the video and the audio would attach. And you can always re-link those together by highlighting them and re-linking that. And so that way they're both moving, video and audio. And as you can kind of been seeing me throughout this video, you can kind of highlight both these clips using the lasso tool. Basically what that is just clicking and then just dragging your mouse or cursor over these clips, and that is lassoing these clips and highlighting them. Say you have a bunch of these clips, just like a down the timeline and whatnot. I'm gonna zoom out a bit. But say you like the where these clips are, but you need these to move down because you're gonna edit these two clips a bit more. So you need some space. Well, what you can do is go over here to this tool right here. So you can do left and right, depending on what you want. But the default is A. So if I select A, be able to just click a certain portion of time. It doesn't have to be on the clip, but it has to be on the track. And you can just drag and just go. So if I want to do it backwards, say if I have two clips, like this, where I'm perfectly fine with what these are, but I don't want them to move at all. You can lock the tracks right here, and it creates these little like chevron type of dealio going on. Put those both, and if I try to grab it, it's just not going to move. It's locked in place. For coloring and whatnot, if you wanted to use a dropper to white balance a shot for whatever reason, let's find a good portion of the area. So you can go into this color section workspace right here with that to transport you into here. You can go to basic correction, and there's this white balance selector right here. You can click the little dropper tool. You can click anywhere in frame and it'll color correct it to make that object white. So if there's something white in your picture and you wanted that to be your basic position, then you can click that. But since this is a little bit blue and I click here, it's going to make everything super orange to counteract that blue. So to make that as white as possible. So it moves the temperature and the tint to try as much as possible to make that white. So maybe if I open up the exposure for a second, you can kind of see how it turns into white. So ignore my disgusting face. I'm just saving the preset for a color. So say I'm doing a look where I love this color correction and all of that. So say I want to save this for another shot for later. What you can do is you can go over here to where it says Lumetri color. You can right click it and you can save a preset and just name it whatever you want. So then that saves a preset in your effects panel. So if you go back to editing and we go to a different shot that's not color corrected, so maybe this one right here. We can go to effect controls or effects first. You go to presets and you can see our little super awesome color portion. So what you can do is you can drag and drop it onto there and have the same color as the other shot right there. So if you compare this shot to that shot, it should look the same. So one of the other things too is you don't want to have just like a random, so say you have two shots right here and you want this to be black for a major portion of the video. What you can do is go over here, new item, then you can go to black video, click okay, just make sure it matches your sequence, and it'll appear up here on your project. What you can do is drag and drop over here, Planetary Timeline, you can expand as if it was in one of these other clips. So then this makes an actual black video that's there. You can hold things in place. And it's almost just like a little stopper for you. So we're going to go jump into one of these. This project for a film that I just edited. For 699, with sound delivery, that's where you want to name your folder. 599 for color delivery, for doing that. But you'll want to first make your sequence, so you just want to double click that. And then that should bring up whatever sequence it is. So this is already pre-built, so I'll just talk it through real fast. One of the things you want to do is you want to make sure your timeline, or your time will play a position thingy. You'll want to make sure that's at 5830, and to change that, what you can do is go to the hamburger, and you can go to start time right here. So that should be able to change your start time. Should be able to be right there. Then what you want to do next is push everything over, so you can use that little selection tool that we talked about earlier. Push everything back, so you can do that. And then what you want to do is you want to get bars and toe, which is this, which I'm sure a lot of people are familiar with. You want to get transparent video. You want to have a little title card, and you'll also want to have a little countdown. So to get the bars and tone on the countdown, you'll just click this new item right here, and it's right here, bars and tone, and universal countdown one. And you'll need a transparent video for that too, for the time code. For the time code, all you have to do is once you put on the transparent video and you go all the way across, while also putting bars and tone on the last bit, one of the very last frames of your movie, just so the sound editor can sync it up. Then what you'll do is you go into effects, you'll just type in time code, drag that onto there, and then you should be able to go into effect controls, and you want to make sure to be able to generate that, and I should be able to pop up a starting time code right here. Then what you want to do is once you drag that across, and you should see those, it will see that video to match. Then what you want to do is place your countdown, then your title sequence. To make this title, I just went to File, New, Legacy Title, and then you should be able to make one of these title cards right here. And then for the HD bars of tone, you'll just put that there. But one of the most important things is you want your start of your movie to be at one. So this movie actually starts out in black, but the sound starts at 1 minute, as you can see. You'll put the 1 minute there. You'll put about maybe 8 seconds-ish of the countdown, the title card, and then whatever is not being filled up, you'll do it. So then when you're done with that, you can just go into File, Export, and you want to do AAF. So what they'll do is they'll simplify the project, and you don't want to mix it down, and you don't want to use tape sources when present, but you want to make sure all of them are in mono, and most of the time you don't want that and render audio effects if you're going to Pro Tools. So you want to make sure your sample rate's that, your bits per sample is 24, embedded audio, AIFF or broadcast wave, just depends on what you're doing. You'll click OK, and it'll tell you where to export it. And I usually have mine exported in my deliverables folder right here under the sound deliverables. So it should be located right there. Then what you want to do is you want to actually export the video itself. So export media, this window should pop up. This, you just want like a very low compressed rate, still HD as much as possible, so that you can see. So Vimeo 720 is one of the best recommended, and you can just like export down here. For color deliverables, all you have to do is you'll go into color delivery. You'll name that 599v1. You still have your bar, you still have all this. But you'll actually will not have that one little frame at the bottom. So what you want to do is you want to make sure your sequence is what you're working on. Then you can go to file, go to export. It'll be Final Cut to Pro XML. You'll open up this. You can pick where to save it. And then you save it into the delivery. So I have mine under my deliverables folder, under color deliverables. As you can kind of see right there. Only problem with that is that you'll still need access to the clips that you have on your timeline. Make sure that you still have access somehow, whether that is exporting a substitutional clip or having the actual clips with you. So obviously that'd be camera or sound stuff, so just in case. So that's pretty much it. It's pretty basic, but it's all great. It's a great editing software. However, if it can stop flipping, crashing, that'd be great. Hope you learned a lot. And yeah.